coming out to our third show of Indians Got Talent. My job is to introduce the MC, and y'all loved her so much last week, we decided to bring her back. Our MC this evening is Miss Mary Sue Boggs. Miss Boggs, she recently worked here, she's recently retired, and she's now teaching speech online, and is now the director of the Fulton Chamber of Commerce. Since taking over the director's position, Miss Boggs has brought great things to Fulton, including the Bluegrass, Blues, and Barbecue Festival that will be this year, April 27th and April 28th. It will feature lots of musical talent that she and her husband Larry discovered during their many travels. Mary Sue and Larry have one child, Taylor Boggs, who works for Delta State University. Go Fighting Oprah, and here is Miss Mary Sue Boggs.
Good evening. Wow, a lot of people heard about all the fine talent we have here at ICC. We have more talent for you tonight. As you can see, it's going to be very interesting. Well, let me get my glasses so that I can give you the exact information. First of all, this is round three of auditions, and we have 14 contestants vying for the chance to make it to the final round on April the 24th. So you might want to go ahead and put that in your phone, April the 24th, so you can be here for the final. And they will become the first ever winner of Indians Got, you know how I have problems with that. Indians have talent, but if you have to say Indians Got, we'll just go with that. Tonight we would like to issue a very special welcome to our president of ICC, Dr. Jay Allen. Dr. Allen is over there, Dr. Allen. Thank you so much for coming tonight, Dr. Allen. And I'm going to explain to you tonight how the judging is going to work. First of all, the contestants tonight will be awarded up to 20 points for the following categories: stage presence, audience engagement, remember that's where you'll get involved, style and appearance, originality, and of course, talent. The top seven scoring contestants will move on to the final round. Okay, so we're going from 14 down to seven. Now, there is a twist, as we like to have. You remember the X's that we have up above? They'll come into play tonight. Each judge can send one contestant through automatically by lighting up their X during the contestant's performance, okay? But the judge only has one, so use them very wisely and preferably not simultaneously. So if you see two X's, it's probably because someone has already voted for their favorite, they're going through, and they just wanted to show some love to somebody who they thought was awesome, okay? So if you see one X, that means that person gets to go through. The rest of the folks, they will be the top seven scoring contestants. And now we're going to meet our fabulous panel of judges. Our first judge of the evening is Paul Dunkley, aka Paul Stone. Paul is an Allstate insurance agent in Saltillo, so please see him for all your insurance needs. Mention you heard it here and get a free pin. Before becoming an insurance agent, he spent over 20 years of his career as a radio personality, most of it with Wizard 106 here in North Mississippi. For the last 12 years, Paul has played guitar with local bands in the area. Paul is also a very talented dancer and comedian. Keep an eye out in your local paper for his interpretive dance and comedy show called I Dance Funny. A couple of little known facts about Paul. He was kicked out of Van Halen in the early 80s for being a better guitar player than Eddie Van Halen, and he used to be a water boy for the Dallas Cowboys. He and his wife Leanne and their two children, Ryan and JD, live in Tupelo. Ladies and gentlemen, Paul Stone. Our second judge of the evening is Mackenzie Kahn. She's a 20-year-old music enthusiast from the small town of Ethelsville, Alabama. And that's not a joke. That's a real place, right? Ethelsville, Alabama. She is currently a cosmetology student at the University Academy of Hair Design in Northport, Alabama. She attended ICC in the year 2016, where she was involved in numerous music events, including choir, chamber choir, center stage, and most importantly, Indian Idol, the precursor to now Indians Got Talent. Mackenzie gained the title of winning the 10th and final season of Indian Idol. Can't believe that went for 10 years. Music has always been an important part of Mackenzie's life, but more importantly, she stands very strong in her faith in Christ. At the grand finale of Idol, she sang the famous hymn, How Great Thou Art, where she expressed how much she owed to God for blessing her with the voice she has. She wanted nothing more than for him to receive all the glory that night. Tonight, Mackenzie would like to thank all of ICC for the opportunity to come home, as she will be playing the role of judge for the competition. Although she is no longer at ICC, she will always be an Indian at heart. Ladies and gentlemen, Mackenzie Khan. Our third judge of the evening is Chance Prestige. Now, Chance is also no stranger to ICC. He was here from 2004 to 2008, where he sang in the shower and was known for sneaking girls in his dorm and playing baseball. He feels as though he would never have been able to play baseball on a college level if not for Dr. Brad Boggs, who coached his little league team. Once Chance realized that we were not a four-year university, he graduated and moved on to Mississippi State, where he completed his four-year degree. He didn't go another 4 years, I'm sure. No, certainly not. In business with a minor in folk music and was president of CCA. You'll have to ask him about that. After MSU, Chance bought a Volkswagen van and traveled the U.S. singing and dancing for Jesus. After several years on the road, he came back to Fulton and began his career at Farm Bureau, so please see him for all your insurance needs and mention that you heard it here and get a free notepad to go with your pen from Paul. Chance still sings for Jesus, but now he only does it in church. He's married to Kayla George, and they have two handsome sons, Caden and Zett. Ladies and gentlemen, Chance Prestige. Our final judge of the evening is Miss Kelly Carlson. Miss Kelly Carlson has been in radio for 25 plus years and currently hosts the afternoon drive on Wizard 106.7. She has just launched her rap career, and you can find her videos on YouTube under DJ Knits a Lot. Her hits like I Knit So Fast My Needles Smoke and Catch Me at the Movies, how about that, can be purchased on iTunes or picked up for free. She is very involved with charity work. Hopefully she doesn't rap for that. She serves on the board of the Salvation Army, and many of you have seen her camping in the mall every Christmas to promote Salvation Army's Angel Tree or Ring That Bell. You should ring and rap. That would be awesome, ringing and rapping. That would be great. Anyway, Kelly enjoys knitting, obviously, interior design, painting, and movies. She is also the unofficial president of the Dolly Parton Fan Club. Kelly has two sassy girls, Stella Rae Carlson and Millie McMillan Carlson, and two nieces, Kaylee and Cora Yielding. Is Cora here tonight? Cora, I meant to bring those golf balls. You lost a lot of golf balls. I found golf balls with Cora's name on them the other day. Who will someday put her in a nursing home of their choice. Oh, that's terrible. But apparently, that's going to happen. Please give all of our judges, including Miss Kelly, a round of applause. Okay, so we have some very interesting judges with a very interesting life, apparently. And even more interesting is our very first act for this evening. Our very first act's name, that's actually a twosome, as you can see. Surely one person would not be playing both of those sets of drums. It's Darius Smith and Jarvis Robertson, and they will be thrilling us with their fabulous drumming this evening. Ladies and gentlemen, Darius and Jarvis.
All right. Was that the same jam y'all did the last time? It is a different one? Okay. One thing that, you know, the other week, playing drums, I'm a guitar player, been in several bands. If you don't have a good drummer, you ain't got nothing. And those guys, number one, the good beat, good groove, good rhythm, but there's two of them doing it. That makes it that much harder. So you guys are great. You can come jam with my band sometime.
I love the outfits. I love that you dress alike. I think you're super talented, and I give you an X. So there, you're going through.
Thank you.
For me, I do think that the act was a little bit repetitive, just like it was the last time. That's what I read in your comments. But overall, you got an X from Kelly. She liked it, so you're going through.
Guys, I thought you did a great job. I think you looked fly there. I think we're going to see more of y'all next time, and keep up the good work and try to mix it up a little bit.
Thank you.
Hey, Jarvis and Darius, you know what I wonder? It's me, I'm here. I wonder, did y'all give y'all's parents headaches though when y'all were little playing those drums? Yeah, that's kind of what I'm thinking. Like, that's the last instrument you want to give your child, isn't that right? And make sure that they can hear themselves only in their way to plug in and they can just hear themselves. That's the way I would. But that was very good. I mean, until you get good, you know, it's going to be a little, whew. Yikes. That, and I don't know if you've ever heard a bad saxophone being played. Whew, that's pretty bad too. My sister learned how to play the saxophone. She thought the only people she could get to listen were the cows. They would all come to the, see, this is a real story. They would come to the edge of the fence and listen to her play the saxophone. So I don't know if they thought it was another cow mooing at them or what. You know, just, anyway, needless to say, she's not still playing the saxophone, okay? I can't say anything because I can't play it either, but anyway. So do I need to tell more musical jokes? I'm gonna run out probably. I'm not gonna sing for you, that's for sure. But boy, these guys are doing a great job. Let's give them a hand. They never get any love. Very good, very good. I can make Russell do an impromptu speech or something. He's really good at that. I'm gonna go ahead and tell you. He's a good speaker. He'll get all embarrassed now. Okay, so we're as soon as we get these off, I'll tell you about a little bit about our next performer. Y'all don't have to be in a hurry. Don't hurt yourself.
Go, Ruffle.
Good job. Good job. Spencer, oh, that's awesome. You're doing great. What am I supposed to call you? Will? Somebody? No, that's not good. Okay, so our next act, as you can see, not quite as elaborate of a setup here, but very, very interesting nonetheless. Her name is Madeline Burdine, and she's going to be playing her handmade guitar. I just think this is fascinating. And foot drum, that's what's out there already. And she'll be singing All My Hope by Crowder. So give her a second to get set up, and she will share that with you. Madeline Burdine.
Yeah.
heard you at the last one, I knew that there was something special about you. You got all 20s for me, a perfect score. I love the originality. I love the cigar box. I love everything about your performance, your style, your bass drum. Everything that I was looking for in your performance right there was the buildup that you did at the end. I wanted you to take that an octave higher. I just felt like it was a little low, and I was waiting, and then finally you gave it to me, and you got an X. I can't wait to see you in the finale.
Thank you.
Mackenzie, I loved you week one, and I love you even better now. Madeline, I love you too. It was fantastic.
I love you too.
I'm still enthralled by the whole you build your own musical instruments. That just blows me away. You should teach a class. Oh my gosh, start a club.
I gotta say, is Philip in here tonight? Philip built his drum right here. That's Philip.
Great job.
I have to give credit where credit's due.
Well, Paul wants one too.
It is original, and I agree with what Mackenzie said, that once you got into that, you got into your zone, and you know that's your zone vocally. That's awesome. And you need to go play at a place called the Blue Canoe in Tupelo. They would love you.
I've been there.
They do original stuff, so good job.
Thank you.
Madeline, I think you did a great job. I really love that song. I think everybody here needs to listen to the words of that song. It's beautiful. And you have a great tone in your voice, and good job. Good luck.
Thank you. I told you, very interesting. Very, very interesting thing. Okay. Next up, our next act is Chris Palmer and Andrew Foreman. I heard a pre-clap, I think. They're going to be playing guitar tonight and singing one of my favorites, She Talks to Angels by the Black Crowes. You guys come on out. There they come. Chris Palmer and Andrew Foreman.
Yeah, we changed it up on the last second, probably like 9, 10 o'clock last night. We sent them a text and went, hey, we're doing a different song, and we're standing now, and, yeah, threw them a curveball, but they did it. They pulled it off.
Mentions the word addiction in certain company. Yeah, she'll tell you that she's an orphan after you meet her family.
She talks to angels. They come around by her name.
She keeps a lock of hair in her pocket. She wears a cross around her neck. Yes, the hair is from a little boy. And the cross is someone she has not met.
I've been here for all of these. You've got probably the most powerful voice of anybody through the whole competition, I think.
Thank you.
And I mean, I love that song. I've played it about a million times. And Chris Robinson, the guy from the Black Crowes, he puts a lot of emotion into it. He did too. So good job.
Thanks.
I'm just blown away by your talent. Love to meet you, and we'll love you now.
Thank you.
You guys just blend so well together, it just blows my mind. You got great scores for me. If I had another X, I'd give you one, but you're going anyway, so great job.
Guys, great chemistry. You know, if I could play the guitar like that, I'd probably stay for my senior year here at ICC. So, great job. Way to go. I would turn left and then back right.
and no matter what, get beat during the fight. I'd run around, trying it all. Still, no matter how high I climbed, all I could do was fall. Maybe this will work. Maybe it'll help me out. All it did was left my life in a state of drought. Then my quest began to look for a new life, to get out of this world that's just full of strife. A world where I seem small and frail, some way to get out of this jail. Then I heard this wise man start to mutter, claiming he knew a way out of the gutter. He said, distrust and give everything. He knew somebody that would wipe my sin clean. And when I did, I finally felt joy. I felt like a kid that just gained a new toy. I found someone who paid for me in full. I found someone who treats me like their prized bull. A person to love me in the bad or the good. A person to hold me no matter where my life stood. Somebody that cared for me, even the broken parts. Somebody that truly did fill my empty heart. Oh, this marvelous love is so true. He saved my life and made me new. And all that's left now is to let it ring. I'm a child of the one true King.
Thank you, Mr. Sandy. That's beautiful. And it takes a lot of courage to get up there and do what you do, man. I'm proud of you. Good job.
Your poem last week as well. The fact that you stood up there and said that you did it through Jesus Christ. You know, it takes a lot of courage to get up there in front of all your peers and say something like that. I also love that you started out in the crowd like that. That really gained the audience attention. So, great job.
I was
going to
say the same thing. I love that you started out there. You totally caught me off guard. And once again, I forgot to score you because I was too enthralled with what you were saying. So, love it.
First, I thought that song was better than the song, as the poem was about it. Shit, but no, it wasn't. Were you meant to, or are you meant to think that?
No, I just kind of want to like leave you hanging, and then like just bring it out at the end. What it really meant.
You need to write this. You need to do this with music. You need to go to Nashville. So good job. Thank you.
From the Broadway musical Hamilton, Savion Lucius.
We have my eyes, we
And is that what you want to do, is musical theater? It is? Well, you're off to a really good start.
Thank you.
Yeah, good job, man. I mean, that's a lot of passion in your voice. I feel like you're holding back a little bit, man. Just push it.
Did I hear them say it's your birthday?
It is.
Happy birthday.
Thank you.
I don't know if you remembered me telling you last time, but one of the main things that I stress during a competition like this is song choice. And I just don't really feel like the song fit your voice tonight, so.
Sadie, I thought you did a good job. Yeah, I thought it was a tough song, but all in all, great voice.
Thank you.
ICC's got talent. We got culture. We got poetry reading happening in here. Broadway musicals being sung. There's gonna be some rap. I'm just telling you, we got it all here at ICC. Next up is Jordan West, and he will be playing guitar and singing Make Me Look Good Again by Drake White. Ladies and gentlemen, Jordan West.
Set? Making me look good again. There you go, baby.
making me the god of.
Yeah, you did a good job, man. Like I said, it's hard to get up there and play and sing at the same time, especially when you don't have a band with you. It's just, you're kind of naked up there in a way, just you and the guitar. And but yeah, good job.
Hey, Jordan.
Hey.
It's not Will, it's Jordan. I'm looking at my composer sheet. I know you can sing. I know you can play. I wrote on your score sheet that I wasn't a big fan of the song choice. I know that's like newer country. I don't feel like the audience could be as engaged because it's new. A lot of people didn't know it, so maybe next time be a little wiser. I know that people can get more engaged when they know and they can sing along. But overall, good job.
All right, thank you.
Jordan, I thought you did a good job. I thought it was a tough song. You know, like Paul said, a lot hard to sit up there and play like you just did. So all in all, I thought you did a great job.
Thank you.
Come with a will, I just put it to the side.
that, man. I think you got some talent.
Yeah.
Good luck.
Appreciate it.
Someone's been practicing.
Yeah, a little bit.
The new tricks tonight. You only dropped it once tonight, but
all
that's
right.
Okay.
It's good.
Good time.
I think you are so talented. I love that. Does it help you pick up girls? Is that how you pick up girls?
Oh, yeah, a little bit.
Yeah. I can see it working.
All right.
Now, anybody who knows Post Malone knows that if he had played Rockstar, the president of the university might have been a little mad about that.
Yeah,
so I'm starting to dig Post Malone now
more. Oh, yeah.
It's really cool, man, watching you do that. The only dig I'll give to you, man, is dress a little snazzier, bro.
Yeah.
I mean, it is a performance.
Yeah, I know. It's hard to do it, though. Shirt tucked in or something. It makes it harder. It's
but that's
team.
Showbiz, bro. Work
it's
it.
It's true. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good job, Adeline. That was a tough song, and I think you know, if you'd have picked a song that's a little easier, you might have gotten the next round. I hope you do, so you can show us something now.
Good job. Just like Chance said, that's a really hard song. I think I told you last week to pick something that complimented your voice a little more. I do think that song complimented your head voice, maybe not your chest voice a little bit, maybe it was a little bit out of your range. But overall, good job.
The only thing I can add to that is, I love you came out barefoot. That's fantastic.
It's something we did in our youth group. Basically, it meant the sense of holy ground.
So that was a contemporary Christian song?
Yes, sir.
It was? Okay. I do like the barefoot. That's cool. You're a beautiful young woman. You did a great job.
Just like
Dennis, 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 you were a hot boy last week, and I kind of think maybe this week's a bit of a hot mess. I'm going to tell you what, though, you were killer on that bass.
Yeah, man, I wish you would have just done a bass thing, and I mean, that would have been just as cool, I thought. But yeah, that's cool. Good jam and song there.
I felt like it was a bit much, the entrance, the track, singing with it, the bass, picking the bass up. I know you had a little bit of trouble with your mic stand not being up there, but I probably would have just picked one, like play or sing.
Dennis, good job, man. Nobody covers Bruno Mars, man. Hey, look, I loved your entrance. I think everybody did, man. You got the crowd going off the bat. If you'd have came out of the singer and played that bass, you'd have been a lot better. Good job.
See?
great plans for you. I wish I had another ex. I love your dancing. It's beautiful. And I love it even more than you do for Jesus. Great job.
Thank you. And a great job. Beautiful song. I thought you did an amazing job. And look forward to seeing you next round.
Love the outfit. Love the song. You were fabulous.
The advantage you have is there may be one or two other dancers. And we all know about, I know that Bruno Mars song, if there's a mistake there. We're not dancers, most people aren't. But I hope you make it through because it was wonderful. And we need something other than a singer in the finals is what I think.
Thank you.
Break out of here.
Y'all, like I said before, it's not that easy to do that without any kind of beat behind you, bass or drums. You guys make it look easy. That I was trying to find a reason to not give you a 20 on one of these, but I couldn't. So good job.
Thank you.
Well, I don't think there's anything prettier than harmony being sung by two siblings, two twins, as a matter of fact. Roommates, that's correct. Great job. You guys are going to the finale. I can't wait to see you there. My faith cleans every. Yay!
Isaiah, I like your outfit as well.
Thank you.
And I thought y'all did an amazing job. You got a beautiful tone in your voice, and you did a great job on that guitar. Look forward to hearing more of y'all.
Thank you.
I just vibed for a little bit.
AJ, I want to know what your rap name is.
Jason Gall.
Gotcha. Hey, look, I like your message that you're trying to get out of your song, man. Just keep doing what you're doing for the right reason. Because you did a good job.
Appreciate it.
AJ, I thought last week that you put a lot more talent on the table when you did the beat, you know, originally. So I would suggest maybe that. But you did a great job. I like the message in your attitude.
Thank you.
That was an original?
Yes, ma'am.
Who sang the backup?
Cookie, remember she, I don't know if she's in here or not, but yeah, there she is. She stayed up with me last night to record this.
There is a whole lot of talent on this campus. That's a great job for you and an awesome job for me too.
Thank you.
I thought you were singing along to a cover. I really did.
That's right.
That's your stuff?
Yes, sir.
That's awesome, man.
Thank you.
I personally am not a hip hop guy, but that's cool. I mean, you got something to say. That's awesome.
Yes, sir. Appreciate it.
So cool to have somebody other than just a singer. Awesome.
Thank you.
y'all, I talk and everything he does. I'm just kidding. I've never taught wrestling. That was something else. In fact, as we're rolling out the piano, I'm going to tell y'all a quick little fun, not sort of a funny, that's not really fun. Back in the day, I went to see this lady perform. Her name was Janet Jackson. And Miss Jackson, oh, must be having issues here. Y'all, are y'all supposed to be doing something? Miss Connie's trying to get y'all, there we go. Anyway, Miss Jackson performed the Velvet Rope Tour, and it was fantastic. But before she went on, there was this very little known dancer and also fabulous singer that we didn't know. His name was Usher. Yeah. So I could see Usher and Janet Jackson. And I don't know, if Preston could sing, he can hang. I'm just saying. Well, we don't know. I haven't heard him sing. Maybe he can sing too. I understand he's also a cheerleader. So, well, my goodness. But everything. Next up is going to be Ethan Foster, and he's going to be playing the piano tonight. I believe he played the guitar last week, if I'm not mistaken. And he's going to be singing an original mashup. So Ethan will come out and grace us. We'll have our last contestant, Ethan Foster.
So first off, just want to say you guys are awesome for sticking around this long. All these acts are awesome, but thank you guys for being here last week and this week. I know it means just as much to everybody else as it does to me, but love you guys.
You had no equal, and now and forever.
How they rolled out the grand piano. That was cool.
Ethan, I loved all of those songs, and I thought that you matched them together perfectly. The change in between each song was just smooth, and I wasn't expecting it. Great job, overall. I loved all of the songs.
Thank you.
Ethan, great stage presence, man. You did a great job getting up there. Love the song. Love going with the hymn at the end. And I just want to commend all you and all the other acts for showing your faith out here tonight. Great job.
Thank you.
Congratulations to all of you for making it to this round. Y'all feel free when they all get out. Let's give them one more big round of applause, please. They did a wonderful job. We know that a couple of folks have already advanced, and so let's go ahead and recognize those folks first. First is Darius and Jarvis, if y'all will step forward. Next is Madeline Burdine. And then we have Chris Palmer and Andrew Foreman. And Isaiah and Carmen Perkins. Okay, so that's who we know is moving on to the final round. The next is our final folks. We actually ended up with a tie, so we're going to do one more tiny twist, and we're going to put eight acts through instead of just the seven. So our next person coming pressing on through is Preston Cooper. The next act moving on is Ethan Foster. Moving through is Kirkland Campbell. And now we're going to take a break. Just kidding. I love doing that. It's so much fun. I understand why they do it. Okay, fine. Our last act moving through is Hannah Faith Cox. Again, thank y'all so much for coming tonight. April the 24th. You want to come back for that, and we will see you then. Have a good night. Be careful.